Hello guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, we'll be checking out the new Unreal Engine 5.7 AI Assistant plugin. Basically, if you don't know, Unreal Engine 5.7 Preview 1 has officially been released and revealed. And along with it, there are a ton of exciting new features, including a brand new AI Assistant plugin that comes built into the engine. Now, we've already seen Epic release an AI Assistant, actually in 5.6. They came out with a Fortnite AI Assistant that can generate verse code and you can use to learn UEFN or the Unreal Editor for Fortnite. But now in 5.7, they're actually introducing a AI assistant just for Unreal Engine itself. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and check it out. So let's go ahead and jump right into the video. All right, so first things first, to actually enable the brand new plugin, you need to make sure that you're, one, using Unreal Engine 5.7. This will not work in the previous version, so anything below that, you won't have the plugin. So I need to go to Edit Plugins and search for the AI Assistant. So you can see we have this AI Assistant plugin. Currently, it's experimental. So go ahead and enable that and restart your editor. So I've already done that. So once you've gone ahead and restarted your editor and enabled the plugin, you just want to go to Window all the way down to AI Assistant. And this is going to pop open the new AI Assistant window. So you can go ahead and dock this window pretty much like any other window in Unreal Engine. In my case, I'll just leave this out like so. Basically, the new AI assistant for Unreal Engine is extremely basic. So as you can see, you can ask anything about UE. And I think the number one question that people are going to ask me is, can this AI assistant basically analyze your project, give you feedback, tell you how to optimize your project, give you some pointers, generate code? And the short answer is it actually does not have any access to your project. So I'm going to ask it, can you review my PP_first-person-character-blueprint? Okay. So I'm going to ask it, can you review my first person character blueprint? And as you can see, it's thinking. And this is basically the response. To review your first person character blueprint effectively, verify the following key points and best practices commonly applied in the UE5 first person character setups. Confirm there's a separate first person mesh camera component, but it actually does not have any ability to review the code. So you can see it's sending us these links, but let's see, can you review my code? Let's go ahead and see if we can ask it if we can review the code. And it says, please provide the code snippet or files you want me to review. So as you can see, it can't actually look into your project. It doesn't have like access or the ability to review the classes. Please refer to my project directory. Let's see if we can ask it again. Direct access to your project directory is not available. So there is your answer right there. The AI assistant can't directly access any of the files in your project, which can be a good or bad thing. Like we've seen, I believe, some AI plugins to Unreal Engine that have access to your code. Their terms of service or their licensing agreement allows them to basically take your code and use it for like training purposes. So there are some cases where you don't want AI to have access to your project. But in this case, since it's Epic Games, the actual creators of UE, you'd probably be a little bit more trustworthy of them having access to your code. And in this case, you probably would want the AI to have access to be able to modify changes, to analyze, code snippets, stuff like that. In this case, it seems that this assistant really is just for asking questions. It's kind of just like having ChatGPT built into the engine as an actual window. So you have to manually copy and paste your code. So let's go to our first person character blueprint over here. And let's see if we can just copy some nodes. Explain the following blueprint nodes. Let's paste what we copied. And I think this is reaching the limit. So let's just do something simple. Okay, let's do input, action, mouse, look, and aim. Paste that. So it looks like you do have like a word limit. You can't even copy. Let's see if we can just copy one single node. Explain this node. So even just copying a blueprint node, it won't even be allowed to send that much information. So it is pretty limited in what you can do. I mean, you can ask it questions like, what is a data asset? Okay, and it can generate information about a data asset. So you can see data asset in Unreal Engine 5 is an asset type that stores structured data in an instance, and then it has some C++ examples, so you can get it to generate C++ code. Let's see, can you generate a simple line trace firing logic blueprint? Okay, so here is the concept. We'll fire a line trace forward from the camera's player's camera. When the fire input is triggered, detect what is hit and show a debug line briefly. We'll also print the hit actor's name. So this is the setup. This is the step-by-step build. So you go into your character blueprint, the first person character, add a input action for fire. So you add a input action fire. I don't think it actually shows you to create that input action asset. So testing instructions, best practices, and also give you some links on the different line traces. You have the single line trace and the multi-line trace. So this might be useful for, you know, walking you through certain steps and asking certain information about a specific classes in Unreal Engine and explaining certain things. Like, let's ask, explain the benefits of soft object references versus casting versus using casting nodes. Let's see if it can explain that. Okay, soft object references, what indirect references to assets stored as asset paths rather than located pointers. Benefits, deferred asset loading, reference assets not fully loaded until explicitly requested, reducing memory usage and load times. However, with the casting nodes, you have the asset loaded all the time. Okay, we have comparison and when to use each. So we have the soft object references, asset loading, and then casting references when you require an asset that already is loaded at runtime. So that's probably like base classes and things like that. Okay, summary, and also some links to the documentation. So yeah, right now the AI assistant is kind of basic. You know, it's not really that advanced in the fact that it can analyze your actual project. It doesn't have access to your project at the moment. Right now it's kind of just a glorified, you know, ChatGPT AI assistant integrated into the engine. I'd like to know your guys' thoughts on this down in the comments down below, because it's just interesting to see Epic release something like this. I mean, in the past, they did release a AI assistant for Unreal Editor for Fortnite, which can actually generate verse code. Now, unfortunately, the AI assistant can't generate like blueprint code at the moment. So it's very limited to, you know, only C++ code, which may or may not be useful for you folks who actually use C++. But for me personally, I use Blueprint, so in my case, this won't be, you know, super useful. It may be useful for, you know, querying information, figuring out, asking for more details about certain features. But in my case, I don't really think at this early stage that it is going to be that useful for me personally. But yeah, I'd like to know your guys' thoughts on this down in the comments down below. Is this something that you might use in developing your Unreal Engine projects? Or is this something that at its current state you won't be interested in using? I know for sure Epic will be updating this in the future. And maybe in the future, they'll add things like the ability to actually have access to your project so it can analyze your blueprint code, tell you, you know, over here you use a casting node, we can convert this to an interface, etc. And maybe you can actually generate code for blueprints other than just C++. So yeah, I'd like to see that be added in the future. But again, this is just something that we'll have to see if Epic is going to continue to update these tools. That's pretty much it for this video. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.